Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about the mass transfer tool within Salesforce. So let's go into our leads and I'll tell you about our use case for this specific tutorial. So I'm on recently viewed, go to all open leads, or I could even go to all leads, but I just want to show you this. So our use case is pretend that I am leaving the company. So I want all of my open leads to go to another person at the company who will be able to take those on and contact those leads, so then we don't have any leads fall through the cracks. So let's go ahead and head into setup and I will show you how to get to the mass transfer tool. In the quick find, I'm going to go to mass transfer. We can do mass transfer approval requests or mass transfer records. All right, now let's go to transfer leads. All right, so now we can do a few different things. We have to transfer from, we can choose a user or a group. I'm gonna go myself to our user Jane Doe. Again, if we could change this from a queue, not a group, queue to a queue, a user to a queue to a user, we'd be able to do this. This also might be helpful if you are getting rid of a queue. So let's say you had a queue of open cases that was for a specific group of people or a specific product line, and that group was going down to just one person. You'd be able to close out that queue and transfer any queue records to the person. Hopefully that made sense. Let's go ahead and create our criteria. So to create our criteria, we have to know what we want to narrow this down by. It'll be similar to any other type of logic that we've done. So for this one, we want to do any open leads. So I'm going to hit lead status is equal to open. Let me grab the exact name. Open, not contacted. Make sure I have that correctly. Now I'm going to hit find and we should be able to see any open, not contacted leads here. If we hit this checkbox, we'd be able to transfer all of them, or we could just do it one by one. But because I'm pretty sure we want to transfer all of these, I'm gonna hit transfer. And it says that it has been successful. So let's go back to all open leads. We have three open. They are assigned to me. We refresh it. We can see that the open not contacted has been transferred to Jane Doe. Now let's go ahead and do this working contacted as well. So then we can transfer those over as well. Now let's grab the working space dash space contacted. Now let's hit find. As you can see, we have a bigger list. These are created by me. Check all of them and transfer. I like to do a quick read over, make sure these are all leads that we want to transfer. But in our use case of me leaving the company, then we want all of my open leads to go to Jane Doe. Now let's go ahead and refresh this lead list and you should see that all of these are going to Jane Doe. I only like to transfer open records to another person because when you are going back and doing research possibly on some closed leads on the process, if Jane Doe was still at the company during that, you might want to go and ask Jane Doe about what that process was like of closing and converting that lead. However, if it was owned by me previously to Jane Doe and it was closed, then it would just create a little bit of confusion and unsurety over who actually closed the lead. So it's just good to only move the ones that you want to and not necessarily all of them. So that is how you mass transfer. You can mass transfer for a bunch of different objects. I would recommend going through and looking at all of these. One particular thing I have not found on here is opportunities. So just be careful with opportunities because you may not find it here. If you found this useful, be sure to give it a like, subscribe if you're feeling generous today. Check out my courses down below in the description box. I have one for new users of Salesforce, the admin certification, and the app builder certification. I also have a website now, salesforceemily.com, and you can join my email list if you want to know about all the happenings with Salesforce Emily. So thank you so much for joining me, and I will catch you in the next one.